Before I forget, we're now giving double entries for the giveaway. Every $5 spent on giveaway merch will now get you twice as many entries. Double your chances at winning a set of HRE full form wheels, Michelin tires, and function and form air suspension to take your ride to the next level. We're going to be announcing the winner live on YouTube on August 7th. Last time we did an overrated car list, y'all got really mad. They ended up all being JDM cars. But I read through every single one of those friggin' angry comments and I took some notes and I learned some things. And one of those things that I learned is, y'all really like to get worked up about how this country of origin's cars are way worse than this country of origin's cars. And I wasn't trying to pick on JDM cars in particular. It just so happens to be where the hype bubble is at this exact moment in time. But since you asked for it so much, we're bringing it back. So how's about we take a stroll down a similarly beloved rabbit hole of enthusiast cars that are surrounded by undeserving clout and false information. Today we're going to talk about the five most overrated European cars. And make sure to stick around for the end of the video. The last car on this list is surely going to rustle some jimmies. Who the f is Jimmy? But before we jump into the trigger train, go ahead and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. We upload every single freaking day and you're not going to want to miss any of the fun. Don't forget to head over to fitmentindustries.com for all of your wheel, tire, and suspension needs. We've also started doing some car review blogs. I'll leave a link to that in the description. I'm Sean from Fitment Industries, SeanB.fi on Instagram. Please stop sending me hate mail.
And you just said Mach 4 Supra turboed. You just lost my respect there, right? The moment you just said that, now I just want your head on a stick. I think everybody else now wants your head on a stick.
Let's get into it. Now, we wouldn't be doing this list any justice if we didn't start out by mentioning one of the most anticipated and hyped up vehicles of the 21st century. After being teased for years by concept designs, promises of a product built on heritage to murder its competition, and speculation of an engine that would rival that of the famous 2JZ GTE, we were delivered a car that didn't quite meet our expectations. It barely outperforms its predecessor and it will cost you more than its competition that runs circles around it. I'm of course talking about the BMW A90 Supra. The new GR Toyota Z4 is surrounded in a big ball of hype simply based on it being a super badge sports car sold under Toyota, riding on the coattails of its also overrated but Toyota engineered older brother. Toyota claims this new BMW will outperform all previous production Toyotas to 60, like a supercharged 2008 Tundra TRD and a 27-year-old Super Turbo. Wow, I'm flabbergasted by its too little too late performance. In all honesty though, the looks have really grown on me. After initially not enjoying the design of the production car until I saw it in person at the 2019 Chicago Auto Show, I've come to the conclusion that Toyota did a fantastic job making it look the part. It looks better than the Z4 by a long shot, but I'm still not sold on the interior. So I don't know. Basic BMW with questionable materials. The Camry TRD I was in after experiencing the Supra felt equal in quality, but more at home with the Toyota brand. I wish Toyota had made it feel as special on the inside as it looks on the outside. The new BMW Supra is an okay enough sports car in a world of disappearing sports cars, and it is 99% BMW Z4 for 93% of BMW Z4 money. So it's not a terrible value for someone in the market for a Z4, but the new German Supra simply doesn't live up to the hype they surrounded themselves with. A 15 horsepower gain after 27 years of production, guys? Come on. You used to murder pony cars and now you can't even keep up with them. So even though I'm glad to see an additional offering of an enthusiast-oriented car with lots of aftermarket support in a world quickly converting to economy cars, the BMW Supra feels like it's just trying to take advantage of a niche market rather than cater to it. So for that reason, I dubbed the Toyota Z4 BMW underdeveloped and overrated. Let's move on. Number two is gonna have to go to my dearly beloved friend, the Volkswagen GTI. The GTI is the staple of hot hatchbacks. Everyone tries to be them and nobody can outsell them, even if they beat them on track. Born to the world in 1975, the 1976 model year with a 108 horsepower, 1.6 liter engine that shot to 60 in 9.2 seconds. Now, you're probably thinking to yourself, dang, that's like not very impressive. And you'd be correct, but that seems to be Volkswagen's bread and butter. Even to this day, a 2020 model year barely makes 100 horsepower over its original rendition after 45 freaking years of German engineering. And all things considered, it's almost double the weight. So even when you double the power, they're not really outdoing themselves. What the frig, VW? I generally do not understand how people are still so hyped about a 220 horsepower GTI, especially with its Focus ST and Veloster N competition. And even with those cars being so much better in performance, GTI snobs continue sticking up their noses at them like they're some sort of more logical hatchback owner. Now, I can't argue with the fact that the GTI interior quality is hard to beat in its segment, and it's not as juvenile looking as the rest, but come on people, how are you spending 20% more money for 25% less performance? I'll be the first to admit I do love me a GTI, but y'all VW engineers are starting to really grind my freaking gears talking about 2020 GTIs making the same horsepower as a 2001 1.8T Audi TT. That's not cool, and as a GTI fan myself, I keep waiting for the day that Volkswagen's gonna bring the GTI to the 20th century. But I guess if people are still buying them regardless, they have no real reason to change. Not enough power, not quick enough on the track, yet they still charge a premium for their product. The Volkswagen GTI is underpowered and overrated. This manufacturer has made a reputation for themselves by creating some of the most beloved, competitive, and capable sports cars in the world. However, along the way, one of them has been encapsulated in a bubble that has them held on a pedestal that doesn't actually represent its real-world performance. I'm of course talking about BMW's E46 M3. After getting the shaft on such limited amounts of four-cylinder E30 M3s, and then receiving the absolute abomination of an M3 for the E36 generation, we were finally given what everyone refers to as the United States' first true BMW M car. It has six individual throttle bodies, a race car-inspired, naturally aspirated six-cylinder engine with 330 horsepower, which was unheard of at the time, and an optional super high-tech sequential manual gearbox. This thing changed the pace for sport touring cars for years to come. And don't get me wrong, it was super impressive for the time, but the hype of the era hasn't seemed to dwindle in the slightest. Even as BMW releases faster, better handling, more exotic, better engineered M cars, the E46 continues to hold its reputation as being the best M car ever. And I don't know if you've ever driven any of these cars, but it's very early 2000s. It is fun to drive and it's plenty quick, but it's nothing crazy. But everyone seems to think these things are friggin' rocket ships, even though they run low 13s with professional magazine drivers and they're getting low 14s in realistic conditions. That's 99 to 04 Mustang numbers. The E92 M3 runs friggin' circles around it, both on track and in the quarter mile. But for some random insane reason, the E46 M3 is now the same money as an equivalent E90 M3. It makes no sense. I mean, frig, these things are actually appreciating in value, and they're even predicted to keep appreciating. The E46 M3 is outperformed and out-engineered by most things in its segment, and it's cemented in time as the first and last real M3 for some reason, and it demands premium money because of it. For that reason, the E46 M3 is overhyped and overrated. The next car on the list is touted as being a Lamborghini-powered, Audi sport-engineered, quattro-driven super sedan. That's right, the C6 Audi S6 made the list. On paper, this thing sounds absolutely insane. I mean, come on, what's not to love about a sport-oriented luxury sedan with a huge displacement Lamborghini-derived 5.2-liter V10? Well, as it turns out, a lot. Maybe one of the biggest turns on about this car is the amount of exoticness for not a lot of money. However, what they don't tell you is that maintaining a $15,000 V10 S6 still costs the same as maintaining an $80,000 V10 S6 like when it was new. But people still see that S6 badge and the V10 designation on the fender and think, dang, that's a nasty fast car, and that's all based around the displacement and the number of cylinders. But these big boys ran the quarter mile in the mid 13s, which isn't necessarily that bad for a full-size sedan, I suppose, but these simply could not compete with their competition. The E55 AMG with its supercharged V8 made 40 more horsepower and 120 more foot-pounds of torque than the Lamborghini-powered sedan. And even the M5 with a smaller displacement V10 made 60 more horsepower and destroyed the S6 on track, in a straight line, and in top speed, yet it demands the same money and attention, and it still does to this day. I don't know how they did it, but Audi found a way to hype up the V10 S6 to be compared competition to the E-Class AMG and BMW's M5, even though they did not compare at all. And for that reason, the C6 Audi S6 is overhyped, overpriced, and overrated. Now for my last trick, I'm gonna need you to do some deep meditation in order for you to contain your soon-to-come overwhelming feeling of rage. The last car on this list defines overinflated demand for an overhyped, underperforming sports car. Perhaps everyone just thinks it's end of an era, last of its kind, old school tech makes it investment worthy, and the thought of that alone drives infinite demand. Or maybe it's just the older generation who hate progression through advancing technology. I'm of course talking about the 993 Porsche 911. The 993 is touted as being the end of an analog era for the enthusiast automobile, and the last manufacturer to resist going out of the box to make strides in progress through change. For some reason, Porsche people see this underdeveloped 911 as pure. Now, I think these people are absolutely nuts, because the scary technology-packed 996 Turbo outperforms not only the 993, but even some of the top supercars at that time in every imaginable way. Hell, even the 996 Carrera dances around the 993 like it hasn't had any marginal development since the 1970s. Unfortunately for the average enthusiast, the 993 happened to fall into the perfect storm of the 911 timeline. The 993 was a perfect 10% better than the outgoing 964, and then the 996 changed too much and put a bad taste in the mouth of purists. Mixed with its questionable and experimental futuristic styling, the 993 911 has become encapsulated inside the Porsche bubble as the last of the air-cooled Porsches, and then is simultaneously touted as the best-looking 911 to ever be produced because of this, which drove up prices drastically. People were upbidding these on the auction block by 30 to 70% for some insane, irrational fear that these would be unobtainable or even worth so much more money in the future. These things went off like Bitcoin in 2017. Fortunately, the prices have stabilized a little bit in late 2018, but they're still extra taxed for no real reason. The 993 911's inflated reputation is based solely around people touting pure analog as better and not around genuine performance or significance, making it actually better than its successors. For this reason, the 993 911 is one of the most overhyped and overrated cars of the decade. Well, guys, that about wraps it up for the 5 most overrated European cars. Be sure to leave a comment about what cars you think are overrated or what you think I might have missed. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. We upload every single freaking day, and you're not going to want to miss any of the fun. Head over to fitmentindustries.com for all of your wheel, tire, and suspension needs, and check out the car review blogs. I'll leave a link in the description for that. I'm Sean from Fitment Industries, SeanB.fi on the IG. Peace.